Romans chapter 15 and Proverbs chapter 24. Romans chapter 15, I am never going to talk about this chapter that I won't first and always zero in on verse 7, because verse 7 forever changed my life. When I studied the breastplate of righteousness and I got to verse 7 and I looked up, accept one another as Christ accepted you. And I looked up the word accept. It says Christ has accepted you. And in the Greek it is pros lambano. And pros means above all, and lambano means to take into this deep, gripping, heart-to-heart hug. And it says, Christ comes to you, and when you have given your life to Jesus, I live for you, you live through me. Jesus comes running up to you in heaven, and he just says, Lord, I know I didn't do everything right. He says, above all, he just takes and just grabs you and holds you to himself. And oh, I long for the day. I long for the day to be held by Christ. And the promise is, above all, he takes you to himself. And we're to do the same with each other. Above all, take people deep into our hearts and hold them. Accept one another. Pros, above all, lambano, deep hug to the heart, as Christ has accepted us. Oh, oh. Oh, forever and ever, that verse will be for all eternity one of the sweetest verses in the Bible to me and to all of us. Let's go over to Proverbs chapter 24. Proverbs 24 is a mountaintop verse. Amy Grant used to have this great song. I love to sing it. I love to pray. I'd love to live on the mountaintop every day. And it's actually, if you miss it, it's actually a play on words. It says, wisdom is too high for a fool. In the assembly at the gate, he has nothing to say. And so it's making a play on words, because in the assembly at the gate, the elders did not sit at the gate, but they actually would sit. The gate had, the walls of the gate were very wide. If you remember in Nehemiah, they had two choirs that crossed each other on top of the gate. So the elders would sit at the top of the gate. That's why the elders were to watch. And so the elders would sit high up. So they were way high up there. And these gates, you know, these walls would be 15, 20, 25 feet high. And so the assembly at the gate was also a real high up place. And so it's making a double play on words. Wisdom is too high for the fool. And being up high in the air with all the wise people, he has nothing to say. And so it's kind of making a play on the words that wisdom is something that's high up in the air. And that has a lot of layers to it. You see, I love to go to the mountains. And most people, I think, do. Because when you get to the mountains, you ever go to Colorado or somewhere or Switzerland, and you get high up there, you can see so far. And something awakens in your heart, and you see so far. And wisdom is looking far ahead. And so there's this play here about sometimes we need to get out of the grub and get up high. And so maybe in the next few months, take a trip to the mountains, get up there high and look up and realize, God, let me look ahead. Let me look ahead to the next few years. Let me always look ahead to eternity, because that's what wisdom calls me to. I want to go high like wisdom is high. May you look high. May you look far ahead today. May you look all the way into eternity and live as you wish you wanted to live when you stand before Jesus in eternity. God bless you. Be the light of Christ this day.